Shalom, peace, blessings, and love to you and your families, and may YAHAWAH bless the sincere as always. So in this video, we're going to go ahead and shun evil. We're going to talk about some serpentine songs that's hypnotizing our people. Proverbs chapter 29, verse 1. Whoever remains stiff-necked after many rebukes will suddenly be destroyed without remedy. When the righteous thrive, the people rejoice. When the wicked rule, the people groan. As it is happening today. Why? Because the wicked are ruling. Now let's read Ecclesiastes 9 and 17. The quiet words of the wise are more to be heeded than the shouts of a ruler of fools. Wisdom is better than weapons of war, but one sinner destroys much good. So again, the Most High God says that all we need is his words. Again, wisdom is better than weapons of war. This is why it says that YAHAWAH loves those who love wisdom. Okay? Those who are spiritual minded. They are the ones who are going to last. They are the ones who are going to be safe. While those who are carnal minded are going to destroy themselves. Like it says here, Isaiah 32 and 16. It says, YAHAWAH's justice will dwell in the desert. His righteousness live in the fertile field. The fruit of that righteousness will be peace. Its effect will be quietness and confidence forever, as we just read. Okay? Again, wisdom is better than weapons of war. So this is our fruit. Alright? Peace instead of war. Now, let us read this. Sorry, we're not done with this yet. Isaiah 32 and 18. My people will live in peaceful dwelling places and secure homes in undisturbed places of rest. Verse 19, key point. Though hail flattens the forest and the city is leveled completely. So this is what it means. In these times and in these days, right, judgment and salvation shall be happening simultaneously, as I say many times, through the Spirit of the Most High. But only those who believe in their God, YAHAWAH, who has no image, who has no form, they're the ones who are going to be led besides these quiet waters, all right? The rebels and the sinners, they're the ones who are going to be flattened with the hailstorm that the Most High God shall send them, will be sending them, okay? So, now we read this. Ecclesiastes 12 and 13. Now all has been heard. Here is the conclusion of the matter. Fear the Most High God, YAHAWAH, and keep his commandments. Why? Because God, your God, YAHAWAH, is a God of his words. Alright? This is why it says to seek his face. So that you can be enlightened by his words. You understand? So that you can know who is your God. So fear the Most High and keep his commandments. For this is the duty of all mankind. You see that? So this is our job. Our job is to fear the Most High and to shun evil. Okay? That is our job. We have to shun evil. So evil is all around us. And the only way for you to shun it is if you fear the Most High God and keep his words and do what is right. You understand? Live spiritually minded, while everybody else is living carnal minded. Obey, while everybody else is making foolish sacrifices. This is what it means to keep his commandments. Alright? Obey. Isaiah 54 and 17 now. It says, no weapon forged against you will prevail. Why? Because we rely on our God. We take refuge in his words. Again, wisdom is better than weapons of war. So that's the reason why it's going to go well with the righteous, with those who believe in the Most High YAHAWAH, their God, those who do not seek help from their government, those who are not trying to take it upon themselves to go out there and kill people and to protest against the police and whatever else out there. Okay, you are the ones who are going to last because you are wise. Okay, so no weapon forged against you will prevail, and you will refute every tongue that accuses you. This is the heritage of the servants of YAHAWAH. This is their vindication from me, declares YAHAWAH. So now let's go ahead and talk about the rebels and those who took refuge in their money and those who basically sold out. Because that's what the Most High God says. Let's go ahead and show you this here. The Most High God says, you profane him for a piece of bread. Look what it says here, Ezekiel 13 and 19. You have profaned me among my people for a few handfuls of barley and scraps of bread. By lying to my people, who listens to lies, you have killed those who should not have died and have spared those who should not live. So now let's go ahead and show you the rebels. Those that have, you know, sold themselves out like Prince, right? Supposedly he's dead, he's forgotten, but his words we can still listen to, right? So let's go ahead and listen to these words of Prince, because Prince was a devil worshiper, for those that don't know. So this is a song, right, from Prince called When Doves Cry. Alright? This is where you originally get, you know, When Thugs Die or When Thugs Cry by Tupac. He get it from here. You understand? It's just his version of when doves cry, rather say. So anyways, let's go ahead and continue here. We don't want to confuse anybody. Let's go ahead and take a listen at this. So, as we know, there's plenty of scriptures where the Most High YAHAWAH talks about these people and how they have sold out and how their mother is a sorceress and how their father is Satan himself. So let's go ahead and read it. In Isaiah 57 and 3. But you come here, you children of a sorceress, you offspring of adulterers and prostitutes, see? His mother's never satisfied. His father's too bold, right? Because that's what Satan said. Satan said that he would serve himself. And their mother, right? Their mother, Isis. Well, you know, she's too demanding, right? She wants you to worship her. She wants you to make drink offerings to her. She wants you to bake cakes for her. See that? But you, come here, you children of a sorceress. You offspring of adulterers and prostitutes. That says, who are you mocking? Because that's all they do. That's why they make their little songs, right? I'm going to talk about their adulterous wisdoms and their, you know, and their mothers, which are prostitutes. So again, who are you mocking, and whom do you sneer and stick out your tongue? Are you not abroad of rebels, the offspring of liars? Isaiah 38 and 14. Look what it says here. I cry like a swift or a thrush. I moan like a mourning dove. See why the Most High God calls them mockers? Okay. Again, I moaned like a mourning dove. My eyes grew weak as I looked to the heavens. I am being threatened. YAHAWAH, come to my aid. Isaiah 59 and 11. We all growl like bears. We moan mournfully like doves. We look for justice, but find none. For deliverance, but it is far away. See that? Even dove have pride. So, Ezekiel 7 and 16. The fugitives who escape will flee to the mountains. Like doves of the valley, they will all mourn, each for their own sins. Alright, so this is why the Most High God says, in these times and in these days, human pride will be laid low. Zechariah 13 and 3. And if anyone still prophesies, their father and mother to whom they were born will say to them, you must die, because you have told lies in Yahweh's name. Then their own parents will stab the one who prophesies. Okay? This is what's going on in these days. An end to idolatry. This is why you people better get with the program. If not, you're going to be left out in darkness. So let's go ahead and take a look at another serpentine song. So this is another one called Karma Chameleon, right? Culture Club. Let's go ahead and take a look at this here. So it says, desert loving in your eyes all the way. If I listened to your lies, what do you say? I'm a man without conviction. I'm a man who doesn't know. And by the way, Boy George, right, which I guess is like the group leader, Boy Judge was a transvestite, or rather say he was, he was gay, right? So this is why it says here that these people are all mockers, okay? Because look what he put here. If I listen to your lies, would you say I'm a man without conviction? I'm a man who doesn't know how to sell a contradiction. You come and go. You come and go. See that? You come and go, you come and go. Loving would be easy if your colors were like my dream. Red, gold, and green. So again, these people worship Satan. Right? We're going to understand these colors here. Red, gold, and green. Some of you people may think, oh, it's talking about some Rastafari stuff. Or it's talking about a flag. But it's not. You understand? It may seem like it. The Most High God tells you how, you know, his people and all peoples are worshiping things that they ain't supposed to. So it's not talking about this, right? But it's rather talking about the serpents, okay? The serpents. Green, gold, red. Red, gold, and green. So this is the reason why the Most High God says that these people, they worship things that you people have no idea about, but you out there, you know, just doing it because everybody else is doing it. Psalms 58 and 4. It says, their venom is like the venom of a snake, like that of a cobra that has stopped its ears. Alright? Notice, it says here, you come and go. The Most High God told you about the serpent saviors, how they come and go. You know, they die, they come back, they die, they come back. The Most High God doesn't die. This is the difference here. See why it says that our rock, or rather say their rock, is not like our rock? Okay, their so-called God is not like our true living God, Yahweh, because he doesn't die. These serpentine saviors, they die. You understand? The Most High God has cursed them. They're not forever. So let's go ahead and read this in Psalms 140 and 3. They make their tongues as sharp as a serpent. The poison of vipers is on their lips. Alright? Talking about their songs. This is why the Most High God says, man, you have to be careful. You have to guard your mind at all causes. Alright? You have to guard your mind because the wicked, they plot iniquity in their mind. All that comes out of their mouths is lies and violence. Verse 4 says, keep me safe, Yahweh, from the hands of the wicked. Why? Because our people have fallen captured into the hands of the wicked. This is the reason why you need to tell your neighbor about themselves. You need to free yourself because nobody else is going to do it for you. Okay? Again, keep me safe, Yahweh, from the hands of the wicked. The Most High God will help you. He's the only one that's going to help you. Nobody else is going to do it for you. Yahweh, your God, has no image. He has no form. This is why you have to get your mind right. You need to seek Yahweh. You need to understand who is your God so that he can keep you safe from the hands of the wicked. All right? Protect me from the violent, who devise ways to trip my feet. We're going to go ahead and show you some ways that our people are, you know, enticed and ensnared by that serpentine magic. Jeremiah 8:17, that says, "See, I will send venomous snakes among you, vipers that cannot be charmed, and they will bite you, declares Yahweh." Some people think this is a game, but we're going to go ahead and show you that it's not. You people have been ensnared. You have been, you know, bitten by the snakes. And it's only on you. It's on you to do, to look at the snake and live, right? Jeremiah 19:15. This is what Yahweh Almighty, the God of Yisrael, says. Listen, I am going to bring on this city and all the villages around it every disaster I pronounced against it. Because why? Because they were stiff-necked and would not listen to my words. But instead, they got ensnared and started listening to the words of their enemies. So that's why the Most High God says that He will give your mind over to whatever it is that you believe in. Okay? Zechariah 7:9. This is what Yahweh Almighty said. Administer true justice. Show mercy and compassion to one another. Do not oppress the widow or the fatherless, the foreigner or the poor. Do not plot evil against each other. But they refused to pay attention. Stubbornly, they turned their backs and covered their ears. You see that? So that's the reason why the Most High God says this here about you people, man. Okay? This is the reason why the Most High God says to make your ears dull. Isaiah 6:9. He said, go and tell this people, be ever hearing, but never understanding. Be ever seeing, but never perceiving. Make the heart of this people closed. Make their ears dull and close their eyes. Otherwise they might see with their eyes, hear with their ears, understand with their hearts, and turn and be healed. So until you do that, the Most High God says, you will be stricken down, and you will be beaten and bitten by the serpents until you are destroyed and you will perish off this earth. That's the reason why the Most High God says that He swear by Himself once again, that every knee will bow and every tongue will swear that Yahweh is God. Verse 12 says, they made their hearts as hard as flint and would not listen to the law or the words that Yahweh Almighty had sent by His Spirit through the earlier prophets. So, Yahweh Almighty was very angry, as it is happening now today. This is the reason why you people couldn't discern your latter end, because you did not take counsel to the Most High, or you didn't seek counsel from the Most High, rather say. You did not, you know, listen to His words, okay? You people out there are still following the ways of your enemies. You're still waiting for lies. Only the sincere servants of the Most High, those are the ones who are being refined with Yahweh's words. This is the reason why we read this here. Malachi 3:16. Then those who feared Yahweh, you see that? So this is talking about a certain amount of brothers and sisters that actually fear. You understand? They actually fear Yahweh, their God. They actually taking this serious. They actually taking this to heart in these times. Only a few of them. Okay? This is referring to. So look what it says. Then those who feared Yahweh talked with each other, and Yahweh listened and heard. A scroll of remembrance was written in His presence concerning those who feared Yahweh and honored His name. Again, all about His name. On the day when I act, says Yahweh Almighty, they will be my treasured possession. I will spare them, just as a father has compassion and spares his son who serves him. Okay? This is the reason why we read this here quickly. Let's see if we can get this. It says here, Micah 1:6, therefore I will make Samaria a heap of rubble, a place for planting vineyards. I will pour her stones into the valley and lay bare her foundation.